Yeah. Nobody was there to even listen. Yeah, yeah. I kept all my problems and kept my feelings hidden. Yeah.
Today we are doing another M Talk episode. So right here I have a bunch of topics and each of us are gonna do like two or three and you know we're gonna talk about it. Okay, so ladies first. Pick the right one. What she gonna pick?
American Son, Kerry Washington. Okay, I didn't
even
see this.
You didn't see this? Okay, so basically if you want to, you can pick another one up because I've seen it.
Yeah, I wanted to see it, so I'm not
going to
talk about it.
It's good, but I've seen it. It's really good, but you should go see it. So you can pick another one up.
Okay, we're going to
put
you down right there.
We're going to put it to
the side. Try this again, take two, okay?
I feel like this one's going to be good.
This is Popeye's.
I'm glad you got it.
I can talk about this one because
did you try the sandwich?
Yes, I actually did.
Was it good? Because I haven't. Okay. I just feel like.
Okay, so honestly, you have to get the spicy chicken one. If you don't get the spicy chicken one, it's probably not gonna be as good. But the sandwich was bomb. Maybe because I was really hungry too, but it was bomb.
I'm glad because I mean I like spicy food anyways, but I feel like I'm gonna get the spicy one rather than the regular one. But I've gotta try it. Everybody says it's good. I'm like,
I think it's the sauce. Like the chicken, it tastes like they Popeye's chicken. Like you eat Popeye's all the time.
So it's the sauce.
I don't know what type of sauce is on it, but it's real good. Like, and I don't even like Popeye's. Like I said, I really not a Popeye's.
Wait, so they put a sauce on the is it just on the spice or is it just both?
I don't know because I haven't tried the regular one.
Cause see the regular spicy. I really just thought the damn sandwich had pickle and damn mayonnaise and damn chicken on it. I ain't really had the sauce.
Is it mayonnaise on there? I don't know, but it's some type of like a special sauce on there. It's so good.
See, now
it's really crispy.
Cause I didn't know about no special sauce.
And I think mine was fresh out. It was freshly cooked too, so it was like
I want to try
immaculate.
It.
So I give Popeye's a 10 out of 10 for that. Cause like I said, I don't even like Popeye's like that. But that sandwich, it bust. It bust for real. It was real good.
I'm gonna try it. And if I do.
We're gonna make a video.
Yeah, if I try, we're gonna try one day, and that's what we're doing. We're gonna try it on here. Yeah,
we're gonna make a video, so stay tuned.
Next week. Okay, what if I pick the wrong one?
Okay, please don't pick the wrong one.
Okay. What would you do if you ever got cheated on by one of your friends? Oh, no, man.
All right.
No, I can't finish the sentence. Basically, it said, like, what would you do if, like, your person, your guy, your boyfriend, your girlfriend, like you find out they cheat on you with a friend.
I already personally experienced that.
I personally experienced as well, but I feel like you should go because I feel like, you know, we should get, you know, both parents. That's just the point of we should get both people point of view. I gotta hear this because
okay. Short story. All right. Story time. So this happens to me in high school, you guys. This is why I have really bad stress issues right now and I'm 21. And that happened in 2016. Okay, so long story short, I was dating this guy for 2 years. Two whole long years. All right. It was prom night. You know, everybody expects something after prom, but I didn't want to because it's my boyfriend, and I just thought we could hang out, and he got mad, so I told him to take me home. Okay, so let's just fast forward. It was like 2 months. Let's say June. It was June. My ex-boyfriend at the time got arrested in South Carolina at this old grad thing that they have somewhere for the seniors with his cousin. And he got out, blah, blah, found, you know, so I was going through my brother's iPad one day because I was getting my hair done when I was doing my hair, and my brother's iPad went off. So I'm looking, I'm like, oh my God, it's my boyfriend's Twitter. I'm not going to say his name, but oh my God, it's his Twitter. So I'm like, let me just see. So I open the messages, open his DMs, and I saw the specific individual who was my best friend at the time in his DMs. So I'm like, why are y'all, you know, DM each other? What do y'all need to discuss? Come to find out, them two, Demon Seeds, had sex together for 2 months behind my back, and I didn't know, and I found out on Twitter. So, with that being said, you guys, I do not trust my female friends with my boyfriend alone. And the first time I had sex, y'all, is was the night he dropped me off after prom. After prom. So you dropped me off at home to go have sex with another individual. I don't understand. It's, oh, that's my phone. I'm going to call her back. But,
somebody.
Yeah. So, I don't, you know, so my trust issue's bad because I just feel like, you know, boys gonna cheat on me again, and I see. So that's it's kind of ruining my kind of situationship I'm in right now. I really like him, but I keep going back because y'all, the boy I'm talking to now has the same birthday as my ex, the same birthday. So I just, they're Geminis. Geminis are crazy. They're twins. They're twins. They're twin sign. They're crazy. And yeah, that's to all Geminis. Y'all are crazy. Y'all can say no, but yes, my grandma, my brother, they're Gemini, so I know how to handle y'all. I'm a Libra. Y'all be having my balance, my scale unbalanced all the time. But it's okay, though. I'm going to let y'all live, but y'all are crazy. It's okay, though. Yeah. Team Geminis. Ooh.
No, ma'am. No, ma'am.
Yeah, but Nick, ooh, excuse me. Not let me say not the N-word. I'm trying to learn, practice not.
Y'all crazy. Dudes are crazy.
But y'all men are crazy. And I,
y'all man telling, with the little pee-pee,
and
y'all
my
crazy.
Future husband, if you're watching this video, some, you know, later down in life, do not have sex with my friend. Because if you do,
somebody want a body bag, and it ain't gonna be me.
It's a problem. And I best believe we will not be together. I'm just gonna politely leave.
Okay? You don't want me to walk out that room. Yeah, if I walk out calmly, that's not a good thing.
If I'm calm,
that's not good. They think that's a good thing. They think they be like off the hook. No, if I walk out calmly,
now
run.
Crazy Imani, then you probably still have some. You just know, okay, yeah.
You
I
have
got
some hope.
Hope
because eventually I'm gonna ride that.
But if I give you calm Imani, just know it's a wrap. It's over. Done.
You might as well just go ahead and make your own funeral. Just go ahead and just lay it out.
Period. Cool. Period. Because, yeah, but that's my little messed up story. What about your story? How did you find out?
This is so crazy. Okay, so really, one time when me and Monty first met, we actually talked about this relationship. And, like, first of all, my last relationship, he was a Gemini. So that's why I totally understood. Because people think Geminis are stiff. People think Geminis are, like, not crazy, but they really are. And it's like, they be doing the most. A lot of people don't believe that. But if you ever date a Gemini, not saying it's going to happen, but if they cheat on you and do some messed up stuff to you, I wouldn't be surprised. And don't come to me being like, oh, well, I told you. Don't believe me. But my last relationship, oh my gosh, it's almost about to be 4 years. Oh my gosh. My last relationship was a good 2017. And I remember that was my first real relationship, my first guy relationship, actually, like, being with someone for a long period of time and, like, actually, like, doing stuff for them. So, long story short, we was dating for, like, a good almost year, and I remember I was, like, I don't like going through people's phones, but I just remember his phone kept do-do-do-do-do. I'm like, okay, you just sitting there, you're not gonna pick it up. I'm just like, you can pick up your phone if you want to. And he just, like, I'm just like, okay. So, I pick it up. So, I look at it, and I just see all these messages. And I'm just like, okay, and then flirtation emojis. I'm like, you know what? I ain't gonna trip. So then I remember I had this Christmas party. And I remember, like, a couple weeks before that, he got me this promise ring. And he was just like, you know, oh my gosh, I know we've been through a lot of stuff, but I would never do you wrong. And I'm just like, I don't believe in all that stuff. And me, like, I'm just like, I ain't gonna lie. Even though Geminis are crazy, I swear, you just wanna keep going back.
They're so pure. They're some pure human beings, y'all. Like, I'm in love with this Gemini right now as we speak. I'm in love with him right now. And I can't believe I just said this on camera, but
it is what it is. Like, Gemini is just something about him. Like, make you just want to hate him, but you still go back to him. You just like, dang, like, I can't. Like, I don't know if I can give you up. And this Christmas party, and my family was over, everything was a good time. This was actually the first, well, they, my family met them before, but it was like the first time, like, where, like, they was actually there. They was actually being introduced. Everything was, like, good. And then, this girl that I was cool with, and we was, like, really close in high school. And I remember, like, she came. She said she was going to come, but then she said she was coming. I was like, okay. So then she came. And, you know, we was playing this game. And, like, it was called, which is gonna relate to what we're going next, it's called Would You Rather. So, like, I remember, like, we was playing the game, and one of the questions was, like, like, have you ever cheated with someone, all that stuff? And I remember a lot of people was like, no, I haven't did that. And she kind of put her hand up halfway. Now, my head, my look, I'm not going to fit anywhere. Trying to do like you're trying to fit anywhere. My blank suspicions was like, something ain't right with that. But I was like, okay. So then, like, I remember, you know, they just kept feeling free. They just kept looking at each other. Like, they met once. They met one time. They wasn't alone by themselves. But I remember they went one time when I had my Halloween party or whatever. And I was like, whoa, that was a good, ooh, that was a long time. That was a good 17, 16, 17. And I remember, you know, they wasn't really right each other, but I did have a party, so like, I was keeping up with everybody. So I remember, like, after we played the game, I remember she had pulled me to the side, and she was just like, can I talk to you for a second? Which is never good. I feel like when someone pulls you to the side like that, and they want to talk to you, I feel like 9 times out of 10,
it's gonna be bad.
Somebody lay some news on you. And I was thinking it wasn't, something about me. Of course, I'm thinking like it was something about somebody else. I thought I was gonna get the tea. I thought I was gonna get the drama. Cause you know, it's good to watch the drama, but it's not good to be in it. She came out her mouth and said, I feel like he's gonna end up telling you because this is the first time like we done been around each other. I'm like, okay. And then she came out her mouth and was like, you know, me and him had a moment. I'm like, what you mean a moment? So I feel my blood racing. I'm just like, okay, breathe. And she said, me and him had sex. Can't say the F word, but they had sex. Now, I'm sure she thought I was going to hit her or something, but I didn't. This is what we're talking about, the calm thing. I literally smiled,
progression,
walked away, went into the room with everybody. I said, y'all gonna have to go. I'm like, there was another time. I'm like, y'all gonna have to go downstairs or something. And like, everybody started to get up, including him. Oh, he just thought he was just gonna be free, left and get up. I said, oh, no. I said, no, baby. I'm like, no, stay right here. I'm real calm. I'm just smiling, cheating. She comes in there. She's like, look, I wanna make no big deal about it. I'm like, just stay right here. I messed that whole room up. If you ever seen me, if any of my friends ever seen me crazy, you don't want to. Like, I tore that whole room up. We was fighting there for about 20 minutes. Like, it took about 10 people to get that person off me. I was like, oh my gosh. Like, and ever since then, like, I just feel like Geminis are crazy. And not just Geminis are crazy. I feel like dudes in general try to play with your feelings. Not yes, all dudes. But I feel like most of these dudes try to play with your feelings. And they love to be like, why are you tripping? Like, I just,
yeah, it's nothing to trip about. You just, you know, get out your feelings. However,
but if you cheating on them, how would they feel? I know.
And that's, you know what? That's the question we're going to have.
Yeah.
What's the double standard? So this is a question for the men too. Even though this is another YouTube by itself.
Oh no, we're gonna do another video.
But the question is, why is it okay for you guys to cheat and expect women to stay? But however, when we cheat and y'all find out, y'all dip.
I don't either.
Y'all want us to take y'all back. Oh my God, I'm sorry, it was a mistake.
They won't take us back.
Please forgive me. But then we even attempt to cheat. Oh, it's a wrap. I'm done with her, bro. She fake. She ain't got no loyalty. Well, that's the same thing. It's vice versa. Where is your loyalty when you went out there and stepped and decided to go mess with somebody else? You have everything and then some in me. But you want to go step out with somebody else? If you want to look at somebody else, what wig you need me to change? I got Jade, I got Keisha, I got Portia. I can switch it up.
No,
so
DMX whoever challenge.
You exactly the DMX challenge real quick. So whoever you want to see that day, just let me know, and then I will let you know. Okay, all right, I understand. You're probably tired of looking at Beyonce, so I'm gonna give you Tiffany tomorrow. That's all you ask. You know, you want to go mess with the real Tiffany that has two legs and walking and breathing, but you don't want to mess with me.
Right, but then they end up coming back.
I'm confused.
Right.
I'm confused.
We're going to do a video about that. Yes, no, when we do that pop-up thing, we're going to double standards. This is a whole video.
You know what? Let's go before we get into
this. This is going to be a whole topic. Oh, I can't wait. See, we can't wait. What's something I'm thinking? Okay. I think
it's my turn.
Okay,
yes. Oh, my God. Hold
on. That's a whole topic, though.
Y'all, this is made heated all over again.
And it's out of experience.
Yeah, personal.
So, okay. Very personal.
This one is weird to me. It says, Janae's Eichel's none of your concern. Ooh.
Okay.
I just listened
to it. I'm going to put a clip of it in here. But yes, how did you feel about it? I have it in my playlist. I listen to it almost every day now.
Yeah, I
just listen to it. Man, what? And when Big C came in.
Big Sean ate up.
Big Sean, bro. Oh my God.
Yeah, Big Sean ate.
I was not expecting.
It's too much for me.
It's a lot.
It's too much for
you
me
have to
handle.
Listen to it. You know, matter of fact, I'm gonna put the link in there too because you have to listen to it. Like, I don't feel like. I mean, of course, you're gonna say it's dope. But I feel like no one can really like explain it of how good it is. You have to listen to it for yourself.
Yeah.
Especially when Big Sean came in.
That's a personal. Yeah, Big Sean's.
It's very personal. It would anybody listen to that?
I don't. They just like they're work husbands and wives. I don't know. They
make it work. You know how they're meant to be together. You know how they don't mix business. Yeah. And they make it work.
They're meant to be together. But it might be some underlying reason. But they're together.
They have to.
But yeah, that's
y'all all have to go listen to that.
I can't even talk about it because it's just too expensive.
Because then
we just gonna move on. Y'all just go hear it.
Yes.
That's just Jesus.
Okay. Reality shows, like, you know, like Love and Hip Hop and stuff like that. Like, do you think, I'm kind of a fan of Love and Hip Hop. Like, I watched Atlanta, I've done watch Hollywood before, stuff like that. But, like, reality shows,
I watched the last time, to be honest, I've been so busy. Like, I was watching Love and Hip Hop Hollywood, and I stopped. I missed one episode, and I haven't watched it.
Missed one, you really can't really watch it again. Yeah. And then, sometimes, like, if I go back home, like, if it's real, I'll binge on it. But I feel like if you miss an episode, it's kind of like if you watch another show, you have to stay in tune. You can't really miss nothing.
I gotta catch up on it.
You miss one episode, you miss a whole lot of time, a whole lot of this person.
And I think the reunion is coming on.
And then a reunion be quick, and I'm like, you know what? I don't know what happened, and now I'm gonna sit here and watch the reunion. I'm not watching it. Don't ask me to watch it because I don't know.
I haven't watched any reality shows recently. I was trying to catch up on Black Ink Crew,
Black Ink Crew. Now that's
yeah, I missed that too.
And I hate that because I used to watch it, but I haven't watched it, and I feel like trying to catch up is
and I missed. And I'm like, I'm not Compton too. I gotta watch the Compton one because that's my area.
You gotta do that during like a whole break.
Yeah, I'm gonna do that during Thanksgiving break because I missed the episodes, and this is my way my life schedule set up. I don't even.
You
got
can't
time
really
for this.
Sit there and binge them. Watch them like catch
I'm
up.
I'm for Thanksgiving because then I'm gonna be done with my homework and I'm gonna be in the house.
Right. You ever seen like you know how like you like Baggers Club and all that stuff?
Yeah, I think they should put Baggers Club like on Hulu.
You heard what they should.
I don't want to be on Baggers Club.
I swear, like if they did like another like season of that.
Do a Baggers Club Clayton County. Call me.
But I feel like they should do something like that. I feel like they bring it back and do something like that. I feel like that would be. Yeah. You talking about it would blow up? A lot of people would be
watching
stuff like that.
They should do another
like
Bad Girls Club Atlanta.
Yeah, they would. I feel like.
I'm old enough. Look.
Oh my gosh.
For me.
Oh my gosh. I still be watching clips of that. Oh my gosh, that's gonna be funny. But I forgot what time was that.
My favorite seasons probably was when they went to Mexico.
I like that one.
And well, let me tell you, I like the whole season was fine. I liked when after Megan beat them up, all the way to the reunion. That one,
man,
and
what?
Probably that one in when they were in Louisiana, New Orleans.
I used to watch that so much. It's like if they bring it back and they do something like Atlanta stuff, I would definitely be watching that. I would definitely have to binge it 5 times to watch that and record and everything like that.
I
just like watching reality shows. I don't know why. Like, people be thinking sometimes cheesy, people think it's good, but
it's entertaining.
It's entertaining. I'm being honest with you. Like I said, I like watching drama as long as I'm not in it. I can watch it all day.
Watching people's other drama be interesting because you just mind your own business.
I can only imagine what would happen if like the security would be kind of slower. What would happen if they...
Somebody would probably get beat up for real.
For real, for real. I feel like they would... Makeup will help you. So then you gotta get it.
Maybe I should be on Bad Girls Club.
Cause I feel like you got that type of person that was like, you ain't taking really no S. Like, you're not taking none of that. Like, that would be.
But I have been working on me though, where like I've like.
And you probably would, you know.
You know, my reaction time has been, you know, more delayed.
Cause sometimes you gotta pick and choose when you wanna get your reaction to people.
But yeah, and depending on the situation, cause if they tear my clothes up, then that's what I'm gonna do.
Okay, that's the part I really want to talk about because, like, I be watching them and they be, like, tearing their clothes up, putting stuff in the pool and stuff. And they don't really be getting that mad.
Yeah.
I be like, you want
the... Yeah, the moment you pick up one of my items...
I feel like you touch my stuff. Right. That's a whole... Like, I don't care what we say between each other, but I feel like you take my stuff, you touching my items that you didn't pay for, I feel like it's a problem. You finna
that's
go.
That's my hard-earned money that I done.
And they feel like it's not a big deal. I'm like, you gonna replace it?
Like, that one season with the Claremont twins, they put all... Yeah.
Oh, I was like... Bruh. And like,
I felt so bad for them because I was like, I could just and they kick and then that nerve to kick them off. I'm like, how do you?
But
kick
you messed
them
with
off?
Their clothes and stuff. What you think they was gonna do?
Like, I was happy actually that they went in the production room and tore the people up, because I would have been mad too. Because, first of all, it's y'all responsibility to stop that. Y'all literally.
Yeah, those are items they called to pay for. Let's
like,
pay
had
for
Gucci
them
and Louis Vuitton in there.
Yeah.
And it's so crazy because they did all that, and look at them now, famous. Except the girl, Shanae, what's her name? Yeah, she in prison right now.
Y'all be trying to mess with these people, but then when they go up and then y'all want to be like, oh, I'm like, no, oh, you remember when you messed with my clothes? Don't forget.
That's the only reason why I couldn't be on Barber's Club, because if my clothes get touched or my bed or any of that, I just feel bad for you.
Okay, so I think we should
go down.
Okay, so this is a game called Would You Ever? And basically, these are just like a bunch of, you know, just different things, you know, just written down. I feel like, you know, we're gonna see what's popping. And yeah. It's like some of them are fun, some of them are weird, some of them are just like very relatable where you just want to be like, you know what? Because you see how we just went off about the whole dudes thing and the whole cheating thing off one of the topics. So you can only imagine.
These was good questions too. These are real good ones.
You want to do them?
It said, we're going to just do a quick brief on them.
We're going to do a quick brief.
So the first one is T.I. Deja's,
No, you got that because you a female. I feel like, how would you feel if your that's just
okay.
A whole topic.
To me, honestly, I think it's like, let's go back to double standards, because I feel like with men, like, they're so hard on their daughters, which I also understand too, because it's like they don't want their daughters to get, not build up a bad reputation for themselves. However, you allow your sons to do whatever they want to do. Let them, you applaud them for having a bunch of girls. And you go to the doctor to make sure that her hymen, but first of all, if you really know your research, a woman's hymen can break easily without having sex.
That's sad.
So that little situation is like, I don't think he should have said that on the internet, because that really is kind of like...
Yeah, especially on the media. You already know your platform. You're going to put that all over like
that's
that.
That's a kind of slap to the face. And that's
you know she still got her comments there, and she still got everything. It's like, that's so embarrassing, because not everybody... I think I saw it, I'm gonna post it. I think they saw something where it was like someone was trying to give her a lot of money to let them. And I'm just like, now we see what your daughter went through because you put that out about her. That's her personal business.
Yeah.
I don't know how mama should do her. Not, you know, she's 18 or so. It's like, why are you even
still going to the doctor?
So a lot of people say that was controlling.
It's
But King, he told him at 14 that he was having sex.
So that's what I'm saying. It's a double standard.
Yeah, because they feel like a lot of people don't believe. I feel like dudes, they feel like dudes do what they want to do. But I feel like with females, because they have this type of standard where they feel like, oh, they're.
I don't
know.
I just didn't like it. I don't even
want to
talk about it
anymore. That would piss me off. Okay, if I have a daughter, that's not my business.
I'm gonna raise her correctly. Where I'm not saying it's okay to just
for her to go have sex with anybody.
Sleep around and just not.
But that's her body.
But to being basically controlling your daughter and not having the same, what's the word I'm looking for? I can't even think about it right now. The same standard as for your son. Then it's a problem.
It should be somewhat equal.
It should be the same.
I know it's different because they got different body parts, but it should be somewhat equal.
Yeah,
I feel like
you shouldn't want your son sleeping around with a bunch of females.
Yeah, because definitely, both genders can catch something. Like,
your son is building a bad
reputation. Yeah, female got a lot more going on down there, but that don't mean that men can't catch nothing just as much. Just saying.
I don't like that conversation.
I don't like that either.
Yeah, T.I.
I'm sorry.
I went to school with his kids.
Messiah, and I went to school with him. I'm just like,
I went to school with them.
So it's just crazy just to see that.
I went to Mount Zion Christian Academy with them.
It's just like, really?
So it's like, I know them personally. So I'm not going to bad talk them. Because
I like
Zionic and them, but that's a situation.
I still like Zionic enough to go to a certain extent now, because it's like, I feel like that. And if I can only imagine what Deja going through. Like, she probably like, just like, that embarrassment. First of all, I don't care if I'm 17, 18. Well, I'm like, first of all, I want my dad going with me to something like that.
Yeah, that's
just embarrassing. But then again, we don't know. We know what kind of happened. We don't really know what full on happened because we're there. So I'm not going to really go into nobody's business because I wasn't there. You only get what people are showing you. But
y'all got that. It's
y'all got that on a lot. But,
I see y'all when I see y'all at Walmart. Right. I see y'all all the time. If your child was gay or wanted to be a transgender, how would you feel? I wouldn't care, honestly. To be honest, if my kid was gay, Baby, we're gonna have you gonna have to be the baddest gay person alive. Like clothes on point. Like I wouldn't. It's just why I don't. Let me. I'm not even gonna have to get a full TV detail. I don't care, baby. Whoever you are, later down life when I have my you know child, because it ain't gonna be now. It's probably gonna be like 26. So whatever. Whatever decision you make, if you like girls, if it's a boy that likes boy, whatever your preference is, so you can believe I'm not gonna judge you because that's not how I was raised. I was raised to love all people for who they are. So if you want to be transgender or if you want to be gay, just know you're gonna be stepping on necks, okay? Because we're not gonna go out there. We look good. The Swanson family looks good all the time. So yeah, you're gonna be the baddest gay person in the room. So yeah, I support the LGBTQ plus community because I mean I always prefer y'all anyway. Because see my mindset is very creative and y'all are very like artistic and open people, so it's like I relate to y'all on a artistic standpoint than just the average normal person, because sometimes normal people might have a little creativity but they not gonna have all the creativity that you want. So like with the gay community, y'all be having that and then some. So like I prefer the gay community than actually like the straight community, because the straight community they just always in somebody's business. I got something to say, but they not I don't mind. So baby, if you watching this years later, if I show you this video years later, trust and believe, if you feel that you are, you know, your sexual preferences, you like the same gender, just go ahead and tell me and I will not be upset. And if trust me, if your father is upset, I'm gonna pick you first before him because you're my child. I carried you. So you ain't gotta worry about that. I got your back forever. As I love you and I don't even know you yet. And that's just that. But I'm done talking. But that's just my preference because that's how I was raised. So, you?
I just really felt that. If I just take a moment, I felt that. I was just over there like...
But that's just me, though. But I just feel like it's no point of judging an individual for what they are. That's just anybody. So, if my kid wants to be gay, then okay. But like I said, if you're going to be gay, you're going to do it 10 times better than the next person. If you want to put on heels, okay, you're going to have some cute heels. We ain't going to wear no bummy heels. You're going to be wearing 4 inches because that's all we wear, okay? So 4 inches are higher.
Right.
four inches are higher. And if you want to be transgender, if you want to wear weave, you're going to have good bundles. We're not giving you no cheap bundles.
Yeah, nothing whack.
Because I have a lot of friends that are transgender. They're very cute. So you're going to be cute because your mom's cute. So, but yeah, like I said, that's just me, though. I don't have any preference of what people do. That's just how you live. And that's just that. I don't see how people judge folks for that. I'm just raised differently. My mindset is different. I'm open to all people. Like, I might be straight, but I love the LGBTQ+ community. I love y'all. Y'all are some creative people. No cap. And that's just me, though. I love the gay community. I do. I really do. Y'all,
the other
bomb. .com. No cap.
I don't know .com was gonna come. I
said .com. Yeah.
Oh my gosh. I can't wait till the next time I do a video, like with mine, like we have like the whole, like, cause it's a lot of, that's a double standard to me too. I just feel like that's a whole, I don't, you would think it should be, you know, whoever they want to be, you know, that's their preference, especially if that's your child. But at first, I would look at it as if that's just how someone raised them, but I feel like the way the world is changing, the way the world is, it shouldn't be like that. I don't care if you wanted to wear a wig. I don't care if you wanted to have the sex change. I don't care what you wanted. If you my child, even if I was straight, if I wasn't gay and I was straight, I still wouldn't care because that's just how I am. Really, even how I was raised, it was just how I am. Like, I know I want nobody to judge me for who I was, so I would want my child
treat people how the way you would like.
And nobody don't ever learn that until it gets done to them.
And honestly, to be honest, that's all learned behavior, though.
Yeah, in general. Like, has nothing to do with gender.
People learn to hate by what they have been around or what they're used to. Yep. So I feel like if you are so homophobic, that's just you're just very miserable. Because they're literally not doing anything to you. And if somebody does come to you and say, it tries to, you know, approach you, all you have to say is, oh, thank you for the compliment, but that's not how I go.
Yeah.
Literally. Because people, gay girls come to me all the time and I just tell them, like, thank you for the compliment, but I'm not gay. I like voice. And then, even on top of that, and if they cool, I'm still friends with them. Like, it's a lot of girls that have had crushes on me that I still talk to all the time. Still check up on them. Because it's no point of being like, oh my God, oh my God. They have a crush on me. They have a crush on me. Yeah, I can't talk to them. Oh my God, it's a girl, one girl. Can't do it.
That's on you. You ask you on a date or something, like, dang.
Yeah, I mean, like, I don't have no issue with it. Like I said,
I don't either, honestly.
Like I said, my kid, if he or she does become gay, just know you're gonna be cute.
Man, what? Oh my God, there was this video. I don't know if you've seen it. Alicia Keys posted a video.
Of her son, because that's the type of parent
I already know I'm gonna be. Like, I don't really care. Like, I feel like, first of all, not only does my child come first, but I feel like if my child wanna have purple, pink nails, if they wanna wear eyeshadow, I don't care. Like, I feel like that's an expression of them trying to find themselves and be who they are, whether they become gay, straight. But I feel like the whole sexual thing is, I like how she said, like, the whole, like, sexual preference thing, it's like really overrated, because I feel like everybody has a little feminine in them, everybody has a little masculine in them, and I'm not saying that means that you will actually wear heels if you're straight on stuff, but I feel like everybody has different sides of them. Like, that's, I just feel like that's just
okay. So, I have a question for you. How do you feel about that, you know, like LGBT stuff in cartoons and kid cartoons, like, what's that show? Hey Arnold? Was it Hey Arnold? Or was it? Or it's one, you know how shows, how they incorporate, you know, gay couples?
Oh, yeah. I don't know what specific cartoon.
Like, how do you feel about that personally? Do you think it's like the agenda is getting pushed too much, or it needs to be implemented in cartoons for kids?
I feel like as long as it's not, especially like cartoons to children, I feel like it can be implemented as long as, of course, not inappropriate, which is a cartoon, so they shouldn't really make it inappropriate anyway. But I feel like it should be, like, just like you see, like, on different cartoons, you know, you see like your mom and dad, and you see it's female and a male. I feel like there should be some times where, like, it might be a male and a male. Like, I feel like when it comes to stuff like that, like you said, creativity. Like, I feel like it should be creative on all aspects. I feel like it shouldn't be just one-sided. Because, I mean, this world is changing, it's growing. And I feel like, you know, that type of community, I feel like it should be implemented in cartoons. Like, movies in general, because I already in movies, so I'm like, it might as well be in cartoons. Because children, when you raise your children, and they're like, what's anyone to watch their favorite cartoon? And that might be in there. As long as it's not inappropriate, and they might ask you, well, mom or dad, like, I see two males together. They might ask them a question. You might want to answer them a question, because regardless, they're going to ask you. Regardless, it's going to be in the world, so why not? As long as it's not inappropriate, it's fine, especially in a cartoon, because kids are going to watch cartoons all day, every day, and I feel like it should be in there. That's just me. Because I feel like y'all be having everything else in the world, especially when you get older and you watch cartoons, and you realize there's some stuff in there you didn't realize, you might as well. That's just me, though.
Yeah, I just
want to
hear. I just gotta
get
that thing.
Might as well. Y'all be having everything else on there. I don't watch SpongeBob, all those cartoons, so every time I look, I'm like, that was it.
A lot of stuff.
I'm like, that's why.
Yeah, watching cartoons now after I
work. You realize.
It's like, dang.
You're gonna have to anyways, because exactly, if you can put sexual things on there, I feel like that whole male to male thing or girl to girl thing is not that bad, because kids are going to absorb things like a sponge anyway, so if they don't watch it on a cartoon, they're going to see it somewhere else.
Facts.
See?
Okay. That's
enough for our podcast. When we do that Popeyes sandwich thing, we're going to do this double standard. We're going to talk about a bunch of stuff double standard, because this is a whole nother
thing. Yeah, it's a whole other video.
But it's really good to talk about it, because it's really realistic, relatable, and it's something that everybody can talk about.
A series with
about.
Marcus and Imani. A whole series. Yeah,
okay, so this is called Would You Ever, and basically it's just like a bunch of stuff. It's weird, funny, relatable. So, like, we're just gonna pick a few out, and we just gonna see. So, ladies first again. So you go ahead and pick one out.
I think green first. We'll do orange.
Orange.
Would you ever truly open up to someone?
Huh. That's funny how the first one you picked out. And okay, my love, my mother, but she it takes her a little bit to open up. People, when she do, she's the bomb. So I'm gonna let you explain it, because this is very personal. That's funny how you picked that out. Wow. Okay, go ahead. Later. It's very hard for you, as you can see, like, because opening up to people is not easy. A lot of, some people can do it, some people can't.
Yeah. That is my problem. That's what I have. This is a very hard question for me. I have issues with, like you said, if you hang out with me, it takes a minute for me to actually get in depth with my personal business with somebody else. Because every time I have the fear of, like, me opening up and it slaps me in the face down later down in life. So, would I open up? Yes, but to a certain extent, because I don't want it, like I said, I don't want it to come back and bite me. Like, I really just have the fear of, like, just somebody taking my life and running with it, and just, it's all my life is on the table. Like, I already was going through a situation right now where I had to cut a friend off this semester because I thought she was my friend. And she just took my personal life and spent it on top of that. Not some of it was true, a lot of it was not true, and she just told everybody. So I just feel like, I don't know, I'm the friend that everybody comes to. That's me. I usually keep up. Mama Swanson. Yeah.
Been talking to her for hours. Oh my gosh,
that's me.
I remember how she let me spend the night on her house. I'm just over there the whole night, just the whole day.
Yeah, I'm the mom. I'm the one that everybody comes to. Like, I think that's another downfall of me. I let people express, and I just keep my feelings to myself.
But you don't need to do. I've told her that for about a year now. Like, and I'm still telling her. It's a work in progress, though, but she's working on it.
Yeah, I'm trying.
But it's a lot because...
I'm trying, y'all.
It's a difference between, like, actually, like, being able to, like, get to know someone, actually let someone get to know you to the full extent. Yeah. Because, like I said, you just had to cut somebody up because they're telling your business. Like, it's like you, and that's one thing, that's the scariest, like, to tell somebody something, and they blur it out to people, and they have nothing to do with them. It's like, I trusted you. And it's hard to get someone's trust back, let alone ever. Like,
that's why I couldn't even accept, forgive her, because I just feel like, once you cross that line.
Even we try to be better cool again, it's like.
And I will always watch you, it's differently. Like,
I don't feel like watching nobody. I feel like if I have to watch you back to back, nah, I'm not doing that.
Yeah, I can't trust you at all. Like, it's no point.
I'm going to tell you something right now. That ain't it. Me and Marty been friends for years and change now, and I have never had her tell nobody about my business. I haven't told nobody. It's just like, if you somebody's real friend or boyfriend, girlfriend, I feel like you should not tell nobody's business. I feel like someone's telling you something personal, they're trusting you to keep that. Like, it's not that hard. Because if they told something about you, I guarantee you, 9 times out of 10, you're going to be ready to fight somebody. You're going to be mad. You're going to want to cut them off. You're going to be like, you don't mess with them no more. None of that. I can't wait till we do the video with my, because it's a double standard. It's a lot of things with that. I totally understand that, because I don't even have a best friend no more. I don't have a best friend no more. Like, it's crazy, because people, you can go from someone to be like, my road dog, my best friend, my ride or die, like, oh, we close, and then it blow up, and it be over 9 times out of 10, something stupid, they telling your business,
Yeah, y'all, I have. She don't like it's that. So weird, because I think my spirit be speaking to me.
I'm telling you, that was a sign from God, because that was crazy how you picked that one up, because she really is hard to open up with people, and that is crazy how you picked that one up. Yeah.
I've been that it's really hard. It's hard for me.
But it's hard for her for a good reason. Like, she ain't just doing it just to be standing, just to open up, because those are her feels, and I feel like to open up to someone, it takes a lot more than people think, because everybody's different. Everybody cuts from the same cloth.
Exactly.
And I feel like,
this is my life on a piece of paper.
Why did it get deep already? It's only the first one. We're going to have to do a video. I ain't think we're going to get this deep, y'all.
I'm going to let Marcus put the rest of them, because this is I'm just getting all the very serious questions.
You know what's funny? How before the video was like, we'll get emotional. I'm
sad now.
I'm going to get my feelings. I'm going to go yesterday. I'm going to get my feelings.
I'm sad. I wish I could eat ice cream, but my face for something.
Girl, what? Dude, you dumb bumps on the plan. Would you ever get another piercing? I mean, I would. I always want a nose piercing, but it's like, I mean, I feel like there's nothing wrong with getting another piercing. I just feel like it just depends where, and it depends if you really want one. Like, I do want a nose piercing. I'm probably going to get one sooner or later.
You should get one. I forgot my nose piercing. I was cleaning my nose today, and I forgot to put it in.
Girl, it won't close up. It's on close up. Well, how long you had on nose piercing? You had this for a minute.
Since ninth grade, and I'm a junior college.
Okay. Yeah, like, you like it? You like having nose piercing?
I love my nose piercing. It's so cute. You just be sitting there. It's my own business.
I feel like it's cute. I have
a total of 7, 8, 9, 10 piercings.
Wait a minute, hold on now. See, hold on now. I'm finna get you. Cause I ain't never known that. You look, I got a past four. I was over here thinking for.
I'm 10. I have 6 in my ear. No, I have 7.
Okay, that's why. Because a lot of people have a lot of piercing in their ears. And I be looking. I guess because the type of ear they have, I be thinking it's like 1 or 2 or 3.
So,
you
know,
you
I
got like 6.
Ears.
Dang.
6, 7.
Yeah.
8, 9, and 10. And the other 10th one is in a secluded, it's an exclusive area. So I'm not going to discuss that.
I have 2 in each ear, and then I have, that's it. Like, I want one of my nose.
You should get your nose. I used to have this one, the sideburn piercing, and it just came out.
I want my nipples pierced, but I'm scared.
My dad has them. It doesn't hurt.
I think come off out of bed.
The second one is probably the one.
But I have a high pain time, so I feel like it wouldn't hurt me. I feel like I just want to get them, but I think I'm just like.
Yeah.
I think somebody has had them, and it's like.
Yeah, my dad has them.
One of them.
Well, my dad had one.
You know what? Like, when I turn 21, I'll probably 9 out of 10 get the nose piercing. And if my crazy stuff get the nipple piercings.
Yeah, get the nose piercing. I love my nose piercing.
Yeah, I like nose piercing too.
I gotta put it back in because I miss it. I'm used to my nose.
Y'all gotta say, because I know you guys was like, I ain't see you on. I was like, okay, yeah, I'm trying to take it out.
I was doing like a skincare routine today. And I
took it out. What? You gotta take care of your skin.
The dead negative cells on my face. I had to remove it today.
Girl, my face has been going through changes because I am a newly vegetarian.
You're vegetarian.
I haven't had meat in a minute. Like, I'm so fit. I've been going through it. Like,
how do you eat Popeyes?
I know, but you're gonna try for me, because I just forgot about that. I really just forgot about that because me and my mom, we started being vegetarian.
I want to be pescatarian.
I heard about it. No, actually, my cousin is pescatarian. She's been like that for a year, and she really loves it. Like, I'm like,
I'm gonna try it for New Year's. That's gonna be my New Year's.
You should. Vegetarian. I tried being a vegetarian and for like a little bit, and I liked it, but then I was like, no, because like that's when I went to college, and I was like, I feel like I'm not gonna make it, but I feel like I can. You should. I feel like that'd be interesting.
I don't even have to eat meat. I just choose to.
So it's not that you don't have to. It's just like that's what you choose to do. And then sometimes it'd be just too good to give up. That's just what you mean.
Okay. I picked orange first and you picked green.
She said she's going to switch up to the green.
This one.
Oh, shoot. Not if that's okay. Just put it back in the bowl.
Don't let it be another serious question.
Okay, it's probably going to be. I highly doubt it. If it is, I'm going to be like, you just got it. It is on you.
Would you ever?
My handwriting is messy.
Would you ever? Okay, you have to read this for me.
Would you ever? Dang, I can't read my own handwriting. That's so sad. Would you ever prank someone who was sleeping?
Oh no.
No,
because that happened to me one time when I was in kindergarten and my mother. No, was it kindergarten? Yes. Let me take it back. 6th grade, and I called my mom. They said I was asleep, and they put hot chocolate.
Huh?
On my face.
What you mean hot? Like, I don't even talk about like hot.
Hot, melted, like, and it burned my face. And I went off and I almost fought. And I had to call my mom. And then my friends were like, oh my God, we were just playing. I said, that's hot chocolate. It's hot, melted chocolate.
Somebody would have been going to body bed. I would have been in jail. I'm sorry, 6th grade.
The most, if I did do a prank, is probably put water.
You can't just pass that by hot chocolate.
Yeah, it's hot chocolate. Melted chocolate on my face. You know how bad it burned?
This hot! It's hot! H-O-T, hot. What do you put hot on your face?
Yeah.
The most thing that might be hot on my body is when I'm in the shower taking a steam good shower with my playlist. Hot chocolate.
Yeah, hot chocolate.
I know that hurt, but my adrenaline been running because I've been fighting everybody there.
It was a sleepover for my friend's birthday, and I got
This is a sleepover?
Yeah.
Oh, no, ma'am. Oh, everybody
and I got my bags, and I left. I didn't even finish the rest of the party.
Oh, ain't no bags. Oh, you would've been a bag already.
I told mom, I said, you have 10 minutes to get here.
Oh, but you have 5.
She came
because
here, and she's like, mommy, no, I said, no, I'm ready.
That's hot chocolate. That could've really been, if it was really, really hotter than that, it could've
and
really.
As beautiful as my skin is, y'all.
Right, I would've never thought. Like, they could've really been really too hot, and it would've, like, burnt.
It's my money.
Them burns ain't nothing to play with.
My money. Let me get up closer so you can see my skincare routine. You see how flawless
clear.
My skin has been?
Clear.
Like,
both wear. Clear.
Period.
Clear.
I can't. Like, this is.
Clear.
Can't nobody touch this. So, yeah. Oh, my
can
face is actually looks great.
It really looks great, actually.
That looks good. Neutrogena. Neutrogena and
them little clay, I've been doing clay masks and stuff, and I've been putting hot towels
them
on my
clay
face.
Masks, no, and that your skin is one of your most important things on your body. I feel like that is.
Yeah. My face has been like, y'all, I'm that, so
yes, bad. Your face is.
I'm so proud of me because my face used to be bad.
Man, what? Like, I swear, like, you take very care of your skin, you be looking like somebody.
Like I said, I haven't eaten ice cream in 2 months. Like, I can eat ice cream, y'all, but it, once I eat ice cream, it pops up on my face. Like,
no, bumps ain't no joke. They'll pop. You'll be like, where this bump came from?
It looks like I break out in hives. But I'm not, it's like, I'm allergic to it, but I'm not. So, I have, last time I had ice cream was in September. And I've been trying to stay away from it, so it's been hard, but I've been doing it. Like,
but I don't think you used to.
Like, some guy it. At Wendy's last night, y'all, he was flirting with me. Yeah,
he
grown
didn't.
Man.
He's trying to get a frosty.
Yeah, he got me a medium frosty.
What you give a frosty?
I gave it to.
Oh, I was about to say, give it to somebody, don't
I? I gave it away.
That's a free frosty.
Yeah, it was free, but I was kind of mad. Cause
dang, when you stop eating it and they give it to you, like, it's free, and I can't, but I've been doing so.
I was, yeah, it was so good looking, too. It was fresh. And I was like, dang, can't even put it in my mouth. And then I was going to take some vinegar, but then I have a pageant Friday. So it's like, don't want to break out my face before the pageant.
And then you got a whole event. It's like, you don't. Because yeah. It'd be that one time, it really break out your face, and you'd be like, dang.
And I wouldn't have time to clear it up. So, yeah.
Sacrifices. But I don't know if I should pick up. Medium? What, man? Had my spoon, my big spoon.
But that thing was huge. And it looked so good. And I was so mad I couldn't eat it.
That willpower rest on my little
bit. Because my favorite ice cream, I'm either eating a cookies and cream ice cream, or I like ice cream with vanilla sprinkles and strawberry syrup.
That's good. I still ain't gonna lie. When I used to go to the Cafe Money, that I really didn't eat ice cream like that until every time we were going at ice cream, and my little sprinkles and my little car.
Yeah. And my face was torn up. My face showed all my face. My mom was like, you ate ice cream today. What?
No, I didn't. Yes, you did. Yes, you did. It's on your butt. Why you got that bump, them hives right there on your forehead.
Yeah, my skin is clear.
Skincare, take care of your skin.
Period.
Oh my gosh.
Important. Make a video on my skincare routine.
You should, because your face is really clear.
I'm really
no, for you really should, no, for real.
I'm
like,
really proud of myself because I really have been doing well.
Because it does a difference
to
your face.
Yeah, that pomegranate and stuff, y'all.
Ooh, pomegranate, that smells good.
Yeah, it's real great. Like, it's like, it just foams up. I just feel so great in the shower. Amazing. What is your question?
It's
intimate? Very deep?
No, ma'am. If it was intimate, I would have been like, all right, I'm head out. Like, it's what about me? It's just funny. Because I would have known. Okay, so it says, would you ever dye your hair even if it turned wrong? I don't know. That's what I hate. I feel like if I want to dye my hair, I feel like I want to have so many issues.
I've dyed my hair plenty of
times. I have so many pictures and photos that I've dyed my hair. I've done all colors. I don't remember what color I have not even done.
I think the only color I haven't done yet is gray.
Yeah. Pretty much. I thought I've done a lot of colors, and I don't remember half the colors I did.
Yeah. Only color I want to try gray. I'm going to try it. But I don't know when. I don't know.
Okay, you tried, you know. Yeah. But everybody look good. Some people really look good on it. Just all depends.
And that's something I'm very terrified it's gonna look ugly on me.
Well, I feel like you should test it out before you, like, you know, you just test it out and see.
But yeah, most of the time, a lot of my colors, they either been accidents.
And they be popping.
Most of them have been accidents. Like, I go for one inspiration and then it be something else and then it just happens to work. So.
And she be popping with every single color she try on, whether it's new or not. I remember that one time we went into the store and was trying on, and he was trying on different hair colors. I was like, that color really looked good.
Yeah, I'm surprised I'd be scared. I don't know why.
I mean, I feel like trying out new things, and most of 9 times out of 10, everything you try be looking good. I feel like you just know your
taste. I've been trying neon green, slime green. Ooh. But I didn't
want to
try because everybody was doing
slime
green at one point.
Everybody was, but then once when everybody's like, you bring it back, you'd be like, look, I did it better.
I'm thinking through. I'm
going to
do a slime green
fog. You should. You might as well. You don't try every other color. You might as well try all them colors,
yeah,
too.
Yeah, so slime green and gray is on my agenda.
You should do it.
Next semester.
You should do it.
Spring break.
You should do it. You need to. Okay. We're going to do like 2 more. And then, okay, so you go first.
Okay, I did. Back to orange.
Back to the next color. What are you trying to feel? Don't be scared.
It's these two that keep speaking to me.
Oh, God, they're speaking to you.
Would you ever re-gift something to someone that was once gifted to you?
This is true black excellence. I want to know if you've done it before. I
don't know. Have I done this before? I don't think I have.
Sorry. Sorry if anybody's watching this. What can you say? Sorry to this man. I'm sorry, but I have. I really have.
I'm sorry, Jasmine.
I have.
No, I haven't.
Every and that's not on purpose. It's just either one time, even just sometimes I was broke, and just sometimes I really just lazy. And I was okay. But it was cute though. You know, y'all clearly y'all liked it because y'all still got it.
See, I haven't had anything. Hasn't happened to me yet. Where somebody would give to somebody.
And I hate when they do it. They think you don't know, or you'd be like.
But have I done to somebody else?
No. I have. Sorry.
I have, like I said, I am really wifey material. And once I'm all into you, yeah.
Ball out. If you cheat on this. No, because not even because of her looks, but just because I've seen her, like, how she is. Like, when she really, like, into someone and the things she'll do for people. It's like, if you do something wrong to this, you gotta go.
I feel special.
And out of one of many people, I'm gonna be the one of the people that's gonna be like, you gotta go out that door right here.
When you're in my circle, I'm really.
Don't break it.
I'm really.
Don't
like,
do it. Because she'll go all after you, like, yeah, for real, though.
I'm a mother. Like, I treat everybody like my cubs.
You don't want to lose this
and
one
if you
at all.
Step over boundaries is the issue.
It's up with it. You, they don't come back. You might as well just go the other direction because there's just no point.
I don't have a lot of people I don't like or that
want. Yeah, so it's like if someone started a problem with you, it's like, what? Huh?
Yeah, I'm kind of.
Yeah, that's a mood. Are y'all on? So why are you doing that?
I don't know why I'm so yawning today, because I'm not sleeping.
No, me, because I've been in bed all day.
I think the weather.
No, it is because it's been raining, it's been cold, and then it's been windy.
Yeah, it's been pneumonia. I've been having pneumonia. Like, last night, I was walking in the rain. Pneumonia.
Please don't.
I'm going to be sick on Monday.
Get the wrong one. Okay. I don't know. What color did I just do?
Okay, do you need the green? Because I just got orange.
I don't know why this one's saying something. I don't know. Would you ever just be a single parent if you couldn't find your one? Get it out of my face. You know what's funny? I wrote that one down because I was talking to my sister. We was talking about stuff like that. We was talking about the whole like if you can't find your match and stuff like that.
See,
you go. I don't want to answer that one.
My mom is a single parent. Like, okay. I plan on getting married first.
And how beautiful, first of all, because you can tell she is such a hard worker. And she's funny. Go ahead, she's funny.
That's an individual. My mother, y'all, is an individual. But, I plan on getting married first. But if life turns out where my significant other walks out on me, I would be a single parent because I've watched my mother do it every day. And she is, this is the only time I'm a curse. She is bomb as hell is what she does. So, yeah. If I have to be a single parent, then it is what it is. I'll just step up to the plate. But do I want to be one? No. Because my mom wasn't one at first. But it just ended up being that way. That she ended up being a single parent. But if I had a choice, no. But if I have to? Well, of course, I'm going to have no choice, but I'm going to do a damn good job at it. My kid ain't going to have to worry about nothing. That's why I don't want to have kids until I am financially stable. Like, I don't want to have kids until I know I don't have to look at the price tag when I go in the store.
Oh, my God.
And I'm not even
talking about that.
And I'm not talking about being famous. I'm talking about being rich.
But just having
being secure
money.
In my
To not have to worry about, let me check my account real quick because
status.
I don't forgot this. Like,
yeah, it's like, I don't want for my child to feel like, dang.
No shade. I don't want kids right now.
Yeah, I don't want kids either. I'm so
I feel like, I mean, no shade to people that be having kids right, but I feel like I know I wouldn't be able to do it, but take care of my whole
selfish.
Child.
I'm selfish.
I better take care of myself.
As
I don't know
right
whole kid.
Because now since I'm in college, like, once I get out of grad school, like, I want to travel the world and stuff.
I feel like you should experience life rather than have a kid. But when you have a kid, a lot of people don't know, you're going to have to just.
Your life changes. And it's going to be good. It's going to be for the good. But however, right now, for me, I know I don't want to have any children. So
enjoy
after
life first before you think about bringing another life into this world.
Baby, unless God has other plans, I'm not aiming for a child till 26. So God, if you're listening, 26. No, 24. No, 23. And surely not 22, because that's next year. And I ain't have no
baby. Oh, please don't. I don't
have no baby.
I don't think I'll be ready.
I don't think I'm going to be ready either. I'm probably going to be my last friend. I'm going to be the last friend to have my kids. My best friend just had a son.
And he told me, he's like, dang, Mark, he ain't gonna have no cousin to be playing with. I said, well, he gonna have a cousin to look over because by the time your son get older, that's when my kid
is gonna be
forming. He gonna probably be 12 by the time I have my kid. I ain't have kids right now.
I don't want kids right now.
27. Yeah, I gotta go Dubai first, Bora Bora. I got places to travel. I'm trying to be on some exclusive, like, passports. Passport is full of stamps.
Not for real. Like, I just know me right now, different with kids. Now, in the future, yeah, it's a good 26, 27. I'll be ready. Yeah. Especially if I know by then, I'll most likely be secure in my bag. Yeah. Like, because I want my child not only to have everything, but, like, I don't want to be going to the store and be like, oh my gosh, I can't get it for that. Like, that's the worst. That would make me feel so bad. Not even just something they would want, but just something that they would need. It'd be like, I can't get it. Like, I got to try to figure out a plan B because I'm not in my bag because I had a kid too soon or like I wasn't ready to have a kid, but I feel like I need to have one up before it's too late. And no, like I'm rushing to have a kid.
I think that's a lot of people's problem. Everybody be rushing trying to have babies.
Yeah, because they feel like they're gonna have them. Like, but if you experience life first, getting your money first, and getting your bag, I feel like you'll be ready to have kids, and then go from there.
Yeah, but that's my first opinion. I support everybody. I'm not.
Hey, everybody has kids.
All young parents, I give it to
because
you.
Because y'all here trying, you know, do what you gotta do for your kid. But I just know for me,
not for me.
Not really.
But those young parents, yep.
Mm-hmm. Y'all got that on lock.
Okay.
What you finna get, Lord? This is on the finale. What you finna pick?
I'm gonna pick two.
Yeah, pick two. We're gonna pick two each of them out. Yeah.
Yep, for the finale. I'm going with ours first.
Okay.
Would you ever be inactive on
social media?
Social media.
You have. Yeah, you have. Yeah, she has. I remember.
That's me already.
It came there like, pow!
I'm really not active on my social media, to be honest with you. I don't post a lot.
That's what I'm finna do.
I'm probably a tweeter. I like to tweet, but
A lot of people more Twitter than anything else.
And even on Twitter, I don't even tweet like that.
Not as much.
I retweet and like stuff. That's usually what I do.
So if
I get inactive on social media,
then I'm not gonna.
It's just because I'm inactive. It's not because.
Yeah, I'm not finna be
in no big situations going on.
Yeah, no.
I'm not really vocal on social media, I don't think.
No.
You wouldn't find out my personal. If you like check my Instagram page, which back, my left drop it so you might get some more followers.
Yeah, like, I'm gonna put it under there too, but she's gonna get y'all a little look. So if y'all watching this, y'all can look at it and give her a follow. Like some pictures. Just follow and not like no pictures. Do a little like you like.
I really don't have one page. I just need to do one page. When is this due? I'm tired. People just, they expect me to do everything. Eli Swanson, Carmen. I sent it. What is she? What? Girl, I already sent it.
Mama Swanson.
What, Jeremy? I gotta finish my paper.
Man, what? College? The papers?
Anyway.
Oh, Lord. Oh, Lord.
Next question. Would you ever name someone, would you ever make someone cry?
This needs to be a meme. That face needs to be a meme. Oh, my gosh. That's a whole meme.
I have made someone cry. But
it happens. You know, it's not on purpose. It just happens.
It makes somebody cry as in what, actually? Like, as in on some spiritual or like.
It could really be both, honestly, because, I mean, sometimes, you know, make people cry because, I mean, they did something you didn't like. Or sometimes people cry, but you might make someone cry not in a bad way because y'all might have a certain conversation, like, spiritually, and it might get into your soul.
I have made somebody cry. I made somebody cry because they wanted to cheat on me, and they didn't think I was going to box up. And, yeah, so they popped up, and I left with another dude.
that wanted to be with me. So, made him cry because of that.
Please don't cheat on me.
I've made somebody cry because I be talking some real good stuff, y'all.
Please don't.
And I make them cry. Like,
please.
Like real conversations. Like, if I get in full, like, mama mode, I be speaking some real good info. Real. I be spitting. No cap. I be spitting.
Spitting no facts.
So, I mean, I have made somebody cry. It ain't nothing. I gotta do another one.
Right. I ain't think we'll get that short. I should be getting the ones I be.
Would you ever fast? I did.
Huh?
Fast? Fasting? Yes.
You fat? Oh, you probably had to.
I fasted before.
How long?
It actually works. I did during the summer, actually. I lost a bunch of weight.
Okay, well, fasting because, like, would you like, just water, nothing, like, what?
Like, because I would meat. I didn't because I meat. Well, I didn't say that. No, I didn't. I did, like, this, like, lemon water fast. Where you just, like, lemon juice and just cleanse everything. It's really not that bad, y'all. Like, you would be surprised, like, when you do fast. I suggest to a fast twice a year because it releases all the toxins that sits in your body. Like, you would be surprised how much. My face cleared. It depends on the thing you do because I did it for about.
Well, for that, well, how long did you do that?
It for like 2 weeks. That's all I tried for 2 weeks. Yeah. This is not bad. It's not really not that hard. You just have to be disciplined. Now, in the beginning, whew, I was about to die. But I had my mama help me. She was like, girl, you're going to do this. So it took me 2 weeks. But it really, once you get it all out, like, I think I'm going to do another one when I go home for Christmas break because once I started eating stuff that I didn't want to, that I was supposed to eat, I was getting sick. But now because I got on campus and that's all we can eat, my body got accumulated to it again. But when I was doing the fast and I got back to eating like little stuff, my body was not sitting with it. Like, I suggest somebody at least do a fast twice a year, like in the beginning and towards the end because it really releases. And it helped, and it also helped clear my face too because it got... Like, all, you know, all that bacteria and stuff, whatever you eat, it sits in your skin. So, like, everything that was in my skin, it was just, my face was red because it was just, like, clear. Like, I'm really, like, a light bright. So, whatever, it shows
up. Her face is really clear. If y'all seen when she went on close, like, it's really clear. Like, it looked really clear.
I suggest fasting is, yeah.
I never did it.
Fasting is good. I like fasting. I'm going to do it when I go home because I need to. I need to lose some weight again.
Girl, what weight? Girl, I hate when people be like, some damn weight.
What? I am.
Girl, ain't no weight.
I need to lose weight.
Ain't no weight.
I like my size. I'm gonna be a size. I'm gonna be 180 pounds.
I do this all the time. Would you ever have dessert for dinner? I do that 9 times out of 10. I do that. That's what's wrong with me now, my fat self. If you could, would you ever build your perfect man? That's a double standard.
I'm gonna make a build a man workshop.
That's a build.
Like a build a bear. Let me make a build a man.
Build a man.
Because if I could build a man,
y'all, I don't know if I would.
Matter of fact, let me describe my dream man and my.
Yeah, you go ahead. I'm waiting for this one. Go ahead.
He's 6'4" taller. He's brown skin, waves, ear piercing. Mm. A nose ring is like a bonus point. Mm. Tattoos. I love me a man with tattoos. Mm. He has to be skinny. Mm. Or medium.
She like her skinny, man. She don't like them.
Yeah. Yo, and more on the small side. Like
she likes. She really like them skinny.
I am in love
she with like them skinny boys.
Men. I don't know what it is, but then y'all are cute. Like work of art. Like, I don't know. I thank y'all for being skinny. But yeah, if you're skinny with like a little bit of muscle, like I don't want like a man, like just enough to be like, ooh.
Okay.
I see you working with something just a little bit.
Oh my gosh.
And he got to learn how to dress, nice teeth, well groomed. He got to learn how to take care of himself. Like, I don't mind a man that gets his nails and feet done. That means I know you're taking care of yourself. Like, but yeah, I gentleman, smart, educated, with a car. I like men that drive. I don't have to drive all the time. With a car, definitely. That's a bonus point.
Yeah, take me somewhere sometimes.
That's 10 points. That's 10 extra points. Like, know how to cook. Really just overall a well put together man. And it's not willing, it is willing to be open with his emotions. With his emotions. Like, if you can get a man that's like romantic and willing to express his feelings, if you're like that, call me.
Just
hit me
call
up.
Me.
Hit my phone. I will drop my number. Let me stop playing. Don't not. But, you know, you could comment on the YouTube video and be like, yeah, I want to call you. Great. If you're that description,
you might as well just go ahead and just come with me with a ring because we're getting married.
I'm probably nobody thought of it. Talking about some good man trying to get you a little.
I said I'm gonna create one. If I could do, if the way the future's making,
it's you going, really could try to build a man for real.
Technology might actually be making you build a man. Trust me, man, if that happens, I'll be the first one in
sign
line.
Sign me up, please.
You wanna do
a test? I'm gonna get and fill out about 10 papers, please.
They're like, sign me my lap. But yeah, I would prefer. But yeah, I'd be skinny though. I don't want no big man.
I don't like them either. I can say that because I've tried it, and it's not even just because of their weight. It's just because I just know.
Yeah, it's not because of their weight.
It just ain't for me, and I don't.
I just
can't really come up with an explanation. I just know I don't.
Yeah, everybody I would say it's preference. It's a weird explanation. Like I've tried a big guy, and not
muscular built, and I just not even husky or muscular. I can't even. I don't know what about. Maybe just not for me. I just
like skinny guys. They're literally all the same.
You'll learn her preference real quick. But
I love being skinny dude. Oh my god, they just fell my heart. Y'all just do something to me.
Your tattoo that hit me. I like them.
Yeah, skinny guys with tattoos.
Oh. You know what?
In waves.
Swimming.
I don't mind a guy with hair, but my preference is with waves. Like, get that brush, daddy. Let me get it. Let me brush your hair for you. Let me brush it. Like, that durag. Let it match my nails. Like, let's do that. Okay. My boyfriend. Thank you.
At first, I was like, I want to build me a man, but I think I will because it's like, who wouldn't want to build a perfect man?
Like, I think the world be weird then.
Yeah, because I wouldn't say perfect for me. I would be like enough. I would add, I would think there would be some things that be wrong with him because that made him human. But I feel like, just enough for me.
Yeah.
Enough for me. So I can be like, that's my man.
Yeah.
That's all I'm gonna do.
Maybe one day I'll find my
street
husband.
you will. I don't know about all that.
I don't know about me either. It's
been
2016.
This must not just be.
It's about to be 2020.
This must not just be last time I was home. This is funny.
What?
But you know how your mom would like come over there, like they'd be like on the phone, they always somewhere. They'd be like, can you take the chicken out the freezer? Can you take something out the freezer so I can cook it? I don't do it. And then they get home and they'd be like, did you take it out the freezer?
My mom don't have to ask me that. Cause
don't ask me. My mom don't have to ask me because I will forget. If I'm cooking, don't ask me because I will forget and you're like, check it out. I'm like, I didn't.
I have done it though, but like. Because I have bad memory.
Because don't ask me to do something like a certain amount of minutes later. Like, if you're going to tell me to do it, just tell me to do it now because I will not do it.
Yeah,
I have
bad memory.
What is this one?
Would you ever?
Oh, I know what this one is. This is out of experience. I know exactly what that one is.
Cover for a friend if their girlfriend or boyfriend asked where they were at.
That one was down there.
Don't put me in that.
Would you?
It's a yeah.
Well, it depends on how close you are.
Yeah, it depends on the close. But with that being said,
just don't even do it.
If we are close, please don't put me in that type of situation. Cause I don't like cheating. I'm really big. I hate.
So it's
cheating.
Like to do that. And
I would like do close. It, but to support,
I would have conversations.
But as soon as you come back in the room, I'm going off. I'm like, do not
do that.
Do that again.
Ever.
And expect me to lie for you. I mean, I would do it for you, but.
But oh, trust me, you getting that backlash from me? I'm like, why would you make me do something like that? That would just hurt my feelings. Like, why would you do that?
I'm just gonna open it.
Had to sit there for hours. Might as well.
Did you ever go to a gun range? Yes, because
we talked about it. I want to go to one. I definitely.
You gotta shoot these people because these people are crazy.
Pop, pop. I seen this thing. It was like a car. It was actually like a little gun. It was like a credit card.
Did you ever ride a horse? I didn't ride a horse. Hi, roommate.
How are you?
I have a big head. So, would you ever put in your purse?
I've done that.
Oh, that's
I did. That's what I did. That's what I did to my last boyfriend from 3 years ago. I literally like they we started talking for like a whole couple months, and then they tried to ask me back out, and I said yes. And what I did was I put X-Lax. Who was that long player? I put X-Lax in their drink, and literally they was they was told they didn't make it to the bathroom. Good memories, good time. I'm that person.
I never did.
It's an experience.
That is bad.
Yep, I'm terrible.
Would you ever go the other way? Girls on girls, guys on guys.
It's too late for me, sorry. But if that's what you want to do, experiment. But I feel like you can't really ever go back. I feel like it's a difference when you experiment and then when you already something, you try to go back. Ain't no go, nah, too. We both can agree strictly. I feel like she'd be like, oh, you're fine, but that would be it.
I think women are attractive.
But that don't mean I'm going to sit there and be with you and stuff with you.
Yeah,
like you're fine, but no.
Yeah, there are pretty women out there. I would give women a girl. When I see a girl is pretty, I would let her know.
I'll tell a girl that you're fine and you're sexy, but I feel like it's not going to happen for me.
Yeah, it's not going to be for me. Don't even look at me at that. I'm not checking that on the box.
Right, I don't want that.
Would you ever give someone a fake number? Yes, I have to, because some of these people be trying.
How many Chinese numbers that Papa John's I gave out? They thought it was my number. No, man.
But now these people getting smart these days. They start calling you right in front of them. Why you? But they be like, okay, let me call your phone.
And that's fine. And guess what? I'm bold. I'm just definitely not bold. I'm like, oh, well, that's,
be calling me
that's what you get for me trying to do it in front of people. Like,
would you ever be sarcastic? Oh, yeah. Who knows
that? That's 24/7 thing with me.
I'm going to say yes.
Like, are you so sarcastic?
Yeah,
well,
I can give you sarcastic.
Learn to love
real
it.
Quick. If you ever have not gone to an HBCU job, that's the only option.
I definitely like it. I never thought about it, but going this, I feel like you should. I feel like it's just like learning your history and your culture, and not even just that, just being around people.
I always said when I go to college, it was going to have to be an HBCU.
Well, I feel like most people, now if you don't, that's you, but I feel like most people usually do it. I feel like it's a good thing, it is. If you're not a college person, it really turns out to be good. Just the environment and just like the different type of things, the organization and stuff.
I love my HBCU. Like, I know, like
she be doing a thing. I don't. She be going to start bracket. She be doing things.
I love my HBCU. Like, I'm like really honestly, like I wouldn't. I always said if once I go to college, it has to be an HBCU because
it's really bomb.
I like my. I love first of all. I love black people. Black people are just amazing.
It's just a whole vibe.
And it's just being, HBCU's experience is no other. Like, I've been to a PWI, like been to an event at PWI, and it's just not the same. It's just, the vibe is just totally
different.
I have better, staffing and better residential stuff and everything else. But other than that, HBCU is nothing like a HBCU experience. But that's just me. Especially for undergrad, I just feel like undergrad is a HBCU experience is the best. Now, maybe when you go to grad school, okay, if you want to go to the PWI, okay, cool. There's nothing wrong with that. You're grown now. You're out. But still, even now, I'm saying when I go to grad school, I'm going to NCAT because I wanted to go to NCAT. That was my first choice. That was my only choice. But I ended up coming to Penn State, which is kind of glad. I made a lot of friendships down here.
Yeah.
But, yeah, I'm an HBCU kid. Yeah, I'm an HBCU all day.
Sorry. Everybody different, everybody like it. Everybody
would you ever kiss a friend? Yes, that's why I'm in a situation now.
Please don't get me started.
That's why I'm in a situation now, y'all.
I ain't got friends, associates, that happened. Just funny that it's hard.
And honestly, I didn't kiss him. He kissed me. And he just...
It's happening.
I'm about to call him when this video's over.
I mean, we young. I feel like we might as well do what we want to do it, get it over with, just roll it back on your
ass. This last one. Would you ever pretend to live a trend just to fit in? Oh. No, pretend to like a trend just to fit in.
Man, that just hit me.
Just to fit in, I'm going to be like the next person. Ew,
and I feel like people be insane. I'd be like, well, okay, just like trends and stuff. Yeah, there's different trends that come and go. But I feel like trying to fit in or do a certain trend and you don't like it or it's like you're trying to do something to fit in, I'm like, you are you. Like, I feel like you shouldn't have to try to fit in.
Yeah,
I feel like if someone don't like it, okay, oh well. You the one that like it and they thought
it matters. I like to step out. I'm the one that has to be the extra one.
Because other people are actually going to like you being yourself rather than being someone. And if someone wants you to do a certain trend, then they're stupid.
Yeah, I'm the friend that I'd rather be overdressed than underdressed.
Yeah. That part. No, for real. I'd rather be like, I'd be somewhere looking good than to be like,
let me make sure I wear this because that's what's in right now. I'll be the one in the first coat.
Trends come and go.
Exactly. I'll be the one in the first coat and a kickback.
Right. Trends come and go. You don't. Being you.
So, yeah. I'm not that type. I ain't that type of person.
I'm not going to change for nobody. Yeah. I learned that the hard way. Like, trying to do stuff. Like, no, if you're not being yourself, then I don't want to be around you. And if you're not going to accept me for being myself, then...
Yeah. I can't just do
that.
I can't fit in with nobody. That's just not me, though.
You should have to fit in. Like, I feel like you'll have a better chance with finding your circle and being who you are just by, you know, doing the thing that you like to do rather than, like, trying to fit into a certain trend or a certain box. Like, shouldn't nobody be in no box. No, ma'am. No, sir. But we is definitely gonna do, like, whenever I do a video, it probably won't be the next video, or whenever I do a video, we definitely are going to do a double standard video, because I feel like it's a lot of double standards, and I feel like it's like in the stuff we were doing, the topic we were discussing, the would you ever stuff, it's just like, it's a lot of double standards that need to be a whole nother video, and a lot of people will relate to, because it's really a lot of people do the double standards with relationships, friends, trends, sexualities. It's a lot of double standards, especially right now in our generation. It's really a lot of double standards.
It is.
Like, it's going to be a whole video, so be on the lookout for that when you look at this face. And I will be adding all her social medias.
Yes, so make sure you
follow. All of that stuff, make sure you follow all that stuff. Keep up with her because she be popping a lot. Like,
stay tuned because
there be a lot of stuff going on.
Body is cooking up.
Y'all think that a lot of people that know her, they be like, oh, you doing that thing? Y'all ain't seen nothing yet. Like, y'all have really not seen nothing yet. Like, she really already whooping the kitchen already. Y'all know what she got going on. She's gonna pop out real quick.
I'm moving in silence, y'all. But next
and that's the best way to go. Nobody should know what's going on until you pop out with it.
I'm claiming it. That is my semester.
Please, no, I'm happy. But don't remind me, please. Don't even.
I'm claiming it next semester. Next semester, stay tuned. Hopefully, it's a lot of positivity at the end of next semester.
And it should be. If it's not, then it's not for you.
Yeah, at the time.
I feel like it's gonna be a lot of positive vibes.
Yeah,
I'm
praying. Fingers crossed, y'all.
Got my toes crossed too. All of that.
Pray for me. Next semester, like I said, I got some things planned.
Yes.
And I'm just praying that they turned out.
It's gonna be good.
I'm gonna cry, y'all.
Don't make me cry already.
I've been crying. I'm like, dang.
We are going to definitely do another video. It's going to be about double standards and all that stuff. So expect to see her face many more times. Make sure y'all follow her social media. I'm going to put them in the bottom. And make sure y'all like, comment, and subscribe. This is M4 Gang, and we are out.